But I'm going to take her hair right from the center here, split it from the top of her ear up to the top like this. Groom it back. Now I want her finish to have a little bit more naturalness to it. So no brushes and combs on the base. Just going to gather the hair together. And I'm just going to split this horizontally into two, just like that. And just like a shoe, I'm going to tie them together, just like that. And what this does is give me a whole series of tails that I can make a chignon or decorate the hair with. Again, that includes like anything you want to do, wave these, ruffle them, braid them, anything. So this just gets the hair separated. Take another section right below it. Up. Do you know, for those of you that have been hairdressing for a long time and sometimes just get really discouraged by new attitudes, different people coming with not the same professional values as you have. Do you know what? We were the same when we were younger, and we wanted to push other people out of the way so the attention could be on us. But you know, it's important to remember that you have the more mature you are as a hairdresser in terms of years, the more you have to offer this industry to help younger people. I always encourage young kids when they go to work in the salon is to make sure in that salon there are people with 20 years experience, 30 years experience, as well as just your friend's age. It's so important to surround yourself with people that you can watch. You don't have to like their work or respect their work, but you have to respect their abilities and their seniority to you. You know, if you're just starting out in this business, I sure recommend that you work as an assistant for 1 year and learn how to operate a station, learn how to service somebody, like to help another stylist, and gain popularity from clients. I did that when I started, and it was easy for me when I was able to start building a clientele, because I knew people, I felt comfortable inviting them to come and see me for an updo or something different like that. But ingrain yourself. Those of you that are the salon owners, you are the ones that have sacrificed for your stylist, have sacrificed lots of different things and hours of work, and you deserve to be in the position that you're in. But as a stylist, don't be jealous of that. Be envious, because that could be you too. Anytime you want. My only advice, and this is very improper for main stage, is that if you decide to leave the salon that you're in, leave also the other stylists. Don't take anyone with you. Build your own life, your own business. It's very heartbreaking when you build up a team and you support people, and then they run off and open up their salon together. It's just not right. Be fair, be square, and you'll be happy and have no guilt later on. I told you that wasn't appropriate for main stage. But you notice when I'm working with the hair, you know, when you're putting a bobby pin in the hair, if your bobby pins are showing up like that, pull that bobby pin out, turn it on its side, and it goes between the hair and won't show up. So I always wait to the end of a style to look at any pins that might be showing. So again, if this was the hair and this was the pin, instead of doing this, do this. Slide it in. Invisible pinning that you can charge $10 extra for. Okay. So I'm just going to take these ends, soften them back a bit. You notice when we're teasing, they're just small sections like that. Small sections. Nice long stroke like that. And put it into position. So when you move it, you're putting your bobby pins in vertically. So I'm putting these bobby pins at 7. I want this to drape quite a bit. So I'm going to just turn that over, step down, slide that pin in. So the techniques that I like to show and that I'm proud to work with, are all about folding the hair. It's just getting the ends to go under. So any pattern, I just want to keep this low. So watch when I pull the tail down, the pin turns over, and I can find a nice little spot for it right there. Get a nice clean surface. Okay, still that pin shows up, but as I draw this hair out, let's see, keep that clean. I'm going to tease it to the other side. And the only thing I'd mention about teasing is that when you tease the hair, move your body in the direction that you want the hair to go, and that's what gives it form. If you're thinking to yourself, I don't even know what to do with that piece, let alone know which way it's going, well, just go one way. If it doesn't work out, go the other. Nice small strokes. Smooth it over. Okay, and this one's going to be at 7 also. So I know you're focused on those bobby pins. Watch what happens. This is at 7. I'm going to turn that over. Just fits into this one. I want to keep this chignon low in, on the top and fuller as we go down the bottom. So watch when this section goes across the head. Oops, keep that smooth. Bobby pin on. Drop it down. Turn it over. Slide it in, crisscross it so it locks together. Now this is more a bridal star style, but you can do this half up. At any time you can stop pulling the hair up that way. Okay, take another section here. Bobby pin on. Now watch, I'm not going to pull the bobby pin down, but I'll pull the tail down so it turns it over, and then step over so it'll fit. Crisscross that bobby pin, lock it together. You notice that I'm not really opening the bobby pins. Oops, sorry, that one's dead. Like that. Okay. Just show you the pattern shaping up back there. Keep a happy look on your face no matter what's happening. You know, the wonderful thing about all of us is we're all in the same business. We have similar experiences with clients. Everybody's a little bit different. But honestly, the funny things that happen in a salon in a day, it makes you just happy to be doing what you're doing. Okay? This chignon is a low chignon. That's why I'm bringing all the ends down. So as I smooth this across, this is 7. I want everything to look like it's going the same way. So when I pull this tail down, I'm going to turn the bobby pin over a little bit on its side like that. How many of you get frustrated when you're doing an updo and you could be doing just what I'm doing right now and thinking to yourself with a big smile on your face, I hope I never see you again. You know, I'm a professional. I don't need to be humiliated by these updos. You know, there's nothing more heartbreaking than having to take an updo down. Oh, it's devastating. So, I mean, what are you going to say to her? Don't you got no taste? No. So this is what I do if I have to take the hair down. I totally understand because this is your day, not my day. And I want you to be happy because although this is your 9th marriage, I still think you've got a chance. You know, I've been working with your family for nearly 50 years and they seem to like what I do. Sometimes doing classic hair this way, you think to yourself, oh, geez, you know what? Like, I'd like it to be this or that or the other thing. That's your prerogative to do. What you can get from Martin Parsons is how to get your bases in, how to get the shape to stay in place. And I really encourage you to come to our new website. We have all kinds of things there. We have a new cutting book out. There's 134 different updos that you can look at, watch. You can subscribe. And if you put your... if you go to martinparsons.edu and put in your email address, you can get one of these looks to watch for 24 hours. Really interesting looks, too. So, okay, that's... Everybody sounded really excited about that. Okay, that's... Instead of just teasing the hair, add a bit of flair. And maybe one leg up at the same time. It's a good thing I find myself so amusing, isn't it? Don't you find that yourself, sometimes at the end of the day, you can go home and you think, you know what? I'm really funny. People just don't get me. It's always somebody else. It's never you. Sometimes people just aren't in the mood for it either. How many of you can see this with a veil? With flowers, potted ferns, anything? Okay. Really simple looks. You know, it's an honor to be here at the premiere show. The people that put this show together are fine people. They care about our industry. They care about you. And everybody wants you to have a good time this weekend and really enjoy it. Okay. I only have 4 jokes. I've been telling you that for years when I come here. Like, this is one of my jokes. Oh, sorry. Excuse me. Drop the comb here. Oh my God. Jesus, give me. Let me just get you a fresh one. Oh, there's one. Okay. That's so bad, isn't it? Now, how many times have you heard that joke? A lot. Okay. Where's our booth number? What's our booth number? Okay. Pick a number. Come to it. That's our booth. Okay. I'll be on the floor. Also, I'd love to talk with you, meet you, get a picture maybe. But if you don't want that, if you come by the booth and you see me but you don't want to talk to me, just don't look at me, okay? Because I'm that type that sits here waiting like a cat. And if you don't come over, okay. So thanks so much.